kick. Not while you're holding guard.
Weirdos.
Like, while you're crouched. There you go. Now you can kick me whenever you want. What's up, guys? It's Demi, and I'm back again with your future king. For more interviews on the basics of Utopia. It's been a while since we've done one of these. And since y'all fuckers can't give me any good ideas for a would you rather be, we're just going to stick with the interviews. So today, we're going to talk about the basic human rights in Utopia. And what, basically, what people are entitled to.
Alright.
And currently, I'm laying on the ground, and he's occasionally stomping me. That's not even a stomp. What the fuck? Would you like me to stand up so you can get that?
I can't get it to come out of there. Yay!
I'm just gonna lay here. Okay, so human rights. What can we look forward to?
All right, well, you had the right to get kicked in the face.
You have the right to remain silent.
Well, basically, all human beings in Utopia will have certain.
What about non-humans? What about non-humans?
Define. Just all animals?
No, not animals. Like, vampires and shit, because by the time Utopia comes around, they're going to feel safe coming out and saying that they exist.
So all,
We got a plan for the possible mythological creatures that might exist.
Sentient, if you're capable of carrying on a conversation, you have certain inalienable rights.
Well, that's how it's supposed to be now, it just isn't.
Yeah, well, this isn't Utopia, this is the United
States of America. You're going to perfect the human rights that we already have.
Well, yeah, like, you have the right to basically, as a human, do whatever the fuck you want to, so long as it's not harming anyone else.
Right, and we've gone over, like, duels in the street and whatnot. That might have been in the video I haven't uploaded yet. But.
Like, personally, I do not approve of meth. But if you want to smoke fucking meth, and you're not giving it or selling it to children, I don't give a fuck. Go smoke some meth and watch your teeth fall out and be a crackhead and be like, as long as you can still do something useful for Utopia, which, if you're a meth head, you probably can't, and you're probably not in Utopia anyways. So, but, like, if you want to snort some coke before you go to work, I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck at all.
As long as you're still capable of doing the work.
As long as you're still capable of doing what it is you do for your purpose in Utopia, you can do whatever as a human. Basically, you're not going to have other human beings deciding what is and is not okay for other human beings to do, so long as you're not interfering with someone else's rights.
Right.
Like, I have the right to say whatever the fuck I want, and you have the right to do whatever you want, so long as that's not covering up my mouth and telling me I can't say what the fuck I want to say, because I will, and you will die if you try to.
Well, I mean, that goes for anyone, not just you, because you specifically, yeah, you'll be at 100 times gravity training by then. But, so basically, the very base right is just do what the fuck ever you want, as long as you are still, as long as doing what you want leaves you capable of working for Utopia and working for humanity. Basic human right, you can do whatever the fuck you want.
Right, well, even up to the point where you can do stupid shit where you're not useful as long as you're not in a citadel. Like, if you choose to leave the conference of a citadel or even a major or minor citadel, because there'll be some super large ones and then some smaller ones. Like,
right. Now, we've been over this. The citadels are pretty much the size of a city, so to choose to live in the citadel might mean you're living with the population of New York City for some of the larger citadels, or you might be living with the population of Stanley with some of the smaller citadels. I mean, it varies. You could be putting up with a lot of people, or you could be putting up with, like, almost nobody. Or you can just go out and live in the wilderness.
Yeah, but if you choose to live in so-called badland areas where it will be virtually lawless, then you can do whatever you want. But as soon as you enter the zone, you're under the jurisdiction of whatever the highest authority is in that area. Like, if it's a rural area, it'll be a ranger. And if it's in a smaller city...
The highest authority would be you.
For the area. But I'm the highest authority for the entire planet, so... That means if I'm flying around and I see someone doing something douchery I don't like, I'll just pull them away and keep going.
Just drop your sword, fly down, grab it. Just drop your sword, grab it like inches above their head. Don't do that again.
If I grab it inches above their head, they're already dead. The air just goes...
It would splatter them. You wouldn't even have to let your sword make contact with the ground. Thoughts on swords, people. They're awesome.
It's a good way to make jello.
It is. So basically, do whatever the fuck you want as long as you're not interfering with other people's rights to do whatever the fuck they want.
Alright, and as long as you live in a citadel, you have the right to food, electricity, communication, which will be the built-in telephone type system in your house.
Now, this is also touching on what I plan on be going more in-depth on in the next video, which will be discussing what's necessity versus luxury, and we'll touch on that. We're going to touch on it a little bit here with rights, but we're going to go more in depth on it with the necessity versus luxury.
Well, yeah, well, your other right would be your right to all your necessities, and
right.
And then another right, of course, will be your right to be able to spend your luxury on whatever you want to spend right. It on. You're not.
Right. There's no one around to tell you, no, you can't buy that.
Yeah.
No, I mean, people will always be there to tell you that's a bad idea. No, I wouldn't waste your money on that, but, I mean, in the end, you do what you want to do with your money anyway,
also,
even
in,
now.
In Utopia, there shouldn't be too many things that would be even considered a waste, because to others, somebody else, right. They might not see the value in it, but it's not going to be made cheaply, that's for sure.
Oh, yeah, but that's what I'm saying. A lot of people, like, my swords, I mean, some of them are cheaply made, but a couple of them by no means are cheaply made, but... There's still people in my life that tell me that's a waste of money. So, I mean, there's still going to be people in your life to tell you that it's wasteful to buy certain things with your luxury credit. But at the same time, it's your fucking credits. You can do whatever the fuck you want with them. And while it may seem like a waste to someone else, it's all about the value you see in it.
Right.
So, do whatever the fuck you want. You're going to have all your necessities. You have the right to spend... to get any luxury you want, provided you have the credits for it, of course. But with everything necessity being provided for you, luxury is going to be pretty easy to get a hold of.
You have the right to information. In Utopia, in every citadel, there will be a massive library, and that massive library will be filled with both physical paper knowledge and digital format knowledge, and you will be able to go there and research and learn anything you want at anytime, as long as, you know, you're off the clock whenever you're not doing your whatever you have to do. There will be nothing in or without the government in Utopia will be completely transparent. So you will have the right to know everything that anybody who's running Utopia at the time is doing. You'll know if they're voting or doing something you don't want them to do.
And I mean, for the most part, the government in Utopia is going to be truest form of democracy anyway, with pretty much a figurehead leader just making sure nobody goes and fucking messes shit up, but...
Well, only up until...
Everything's going to be decided on, basically, by the people, once everything
I plan on staying king and for an entire generation. That way, I can have the educational system set up and working and everything. All the systems, really, should be in place
for
and working.
Generations.
For at least one or two generations. That way, we have... well-educated people ready to lead our world, rather, right. Instead of just throwing it in on somebody who hasn't grown up in Utopia. When you've grown up in Utopia, you're more prepared to be part of it and
right.
Be a leader in Utopia
rather than someone who's just been a part of Utopia since the day it began.
Yeah.
Because the day it began, they might have been 30 years old and not prepared, fully prepared to actually become a utopian. But now a little bit off topic, but whenever you do finally leave, just a quick question, whenever you do finally leave and let the people run Utopia, what are your plans for the Outland, like the part of the world that's not Utopia, be it Canada or Greenland or Iceland or whatever, if the new utopian leaders, in a manner of speaking, decide that they want to take that too and make that part of Utopia.
Well,
would you be against it?
I want to expand the edges of Utopia all the way to the end of our solar system, minus the one tiny part that they're not gonna that we're gonna leave for people to just go and do whatever they want.
Right.
So that little.
So eventually, if they were to take over that part of Earth as Utopia, then it really wouldn't matter because there'd be other planets inhabitable that are outside of Utopian boundaries.
Well, Utopia itself will consist of our entire solar system, and once you get out of the solar system, which you will be allowed to do,
it will be possible.
Our space program, which is going to be ridiculous once I get everything, once Utopia itself is set up, space is going to be the next thing, and anyone who wants to go into space will have already mastered 100 times gravity, and these will be the most select individuals. People who could do anything they wanted in Utopia. People who are so smart and so physically,
capable.
Good specimens, you know, they got good genes. These people are the ones who are going to be like, do you want to be, what do you want to be? Tell me, and we'll let you do it. And they could be a guardian or a detective or whatever the hell they wanted to do at all. They had free choice. If they chose to go to space, they could master 100 times gravity and leave our solar system and do whatever they want. Utopian laws do not apply outside of our solar system, and I want it to stay that way.
So once they leave the solar system, they can start taking over other galaxies and shit.
Once they leave our solar system, they can do whatever the fuck they want, because the Utopian laws only apply to Utopia.
So it really doesn't matter what they do outside of there. It's not so much they can do whatever they want. It's just, I'm not going to stop them.
Yeah, exactly.
And
the only person, the only people in Utopia who will be able to use gravity higher than 100 times will be people leaving Utopia. Because I will allow you to rig up your ship that you're leaving with up to 500 times gravity when you
leave.
So
you can train while you're leaving.
So you can train when you're leaving and wherever you go, and you can do whatever you want, because at that point you're out of my hair and I don't care. You're not my problem anymore. You're fucking universe's problem.
Now, once you've taken over...
But also, you'll have to pass some... You'll be mentally acute.
Right.
But
you'll be smart.
You won't be a retard going out into space with way too much muscle, so...
But, now once you've established Utopia on Earth and as a solar system, then what are your plans after that? Because there's really... I mean, even if that takes until the very end of your life anyway, but by the time... If everything works out the way you've planned, you're not going to die until you say, okay, I'm done.
Yeah.
So, I mean, what are your plans once you get done with the solar system?
Once I've got the solar system set up and we have people who are living in space, and you have jobs that are in space, like mining asteroids and building ships out in space and whatever the hell you want to do in space, and you can live on Earth or go out in space, or you can explore space, or you can do whatever you want. Once I have all that set up and I've raised my child not to be my heir, but to... hopefully be a guardian. I'm going to try to push him to be a guardian, which is the most powerful you can be.
But, I mean, they're still going to be able to do whatever they want.
Yeah, I mean...
Because they're a utopian citizen.
If he wants to be an artist or whatever, I'll be like, fine, you have that right, because you grew up in... you grew up in Utopia. If I had grown up in Utopia, I probably would have ended up being an anime creator or something like that, instead of...
Rather than the creator of Utopia.
Instead of some sort of...
Instead of an anime creator.
Yeah.
Because you're pretty much creating an anime,
it's just gonna expand the globe, and
yeah, it's gonna
the
be
solar
real.
System.
It's just gonna be real.
You're gonna be able to touch it.
But anyway, more on human rights. That was a bit off topic, but more on human rights. You got the right to do whatever you want. You got the right to all your necessities.
You have a right to all religion, unless your religion has some sort of anti-human thing to it, like.
Human sacrifice is frowned upon.
That's what I was getting. I was trying to think of the Aztecs, right? I couldn't remember
the
name
Aztec.
The Aztecs had human sacrifices in their religion. So,
right.
The Aztec religion currently is illegal to worship and will still be illegal to worship. You will not be allowed to become an Aztec.
Well, I mean, you can, but you can't sacrifice people to your gods, so you'd pretty much be destroyed by your gods.
You can't really worship your Aztec gods unless, of course, you decide to just hang out in the lawless areas.
Right, and then just happen to sacrifice passersby.
Yeah, but even that kind of stuff is not going to work. Cannibalism. Cannibalism will not be illegal.
Cannibalism isn't illegal. The only things illegal are methods of attaining a body.
Okay, well, okay, even if you say so, I don't know for sure, but...
Really, there is no, there is not a single law against cannibalism.
Well, but it will stay laws, that way.
There are laws against murder, there are laws against grave robbing, and defacing a crime scene, or something like that, whatever it's called. You can't mess with a crime scene, you can't grave rob, and you can't kill people, and those are the only real methods of obtaining a body.
Right. Well, in Unova, there will be no law against cannibalism, but like you just said, the laws against eating people, I mean killing people to eat them, is going to be a thing. You know, like, you can't just walk up to somebody like, you know what, I'm hungry, stab. Can't do that. Sorry, guys.
Now, if you win a death battle, though, in a Coliseum, you have free reigns to the body.
If you are in a Coliseum fight with that person, and y'all both sign the waivers that he's fucked, and you can eat that motherfucker, that's what you want to do. In fact, you can eat him raw.
Once you know you're both going to die, you can just rip into his chest, pull out a still beating heart, take a bite, and then hold it up in the air as the crowd chants your name. You can do whatever the fuck you want. As long as it is legal murder, you can eat the body. Or if... but, I mean, like, if...
And grave robbing's not even going to be a thing, because, like I already discussed earlier, I don't like the idea of cemeteries. They just waste space. Now, previously, when we did bury people, a long time ago, when we first started burying people for religious purposes and such, we didn't put the headstones up like we do now.
Right.
We just buried them and then forgot about them.
Right.
And they went back to the earth, and that was one thing. But now we have all these headstones that are taking up space and these caskets that are underground,
like,
floating,
reserved spaces. Reserved spaces that can do absolutely nothing except tell you, hey, there's a dead person here.
Or was a dead person here 100 years ago that no one even knows.
No one knows, no one remembers, no one cares about. Like, there's no one even left alive that still loves this person.
It's just
it's sad
in
to
the
think
way.
About, really. It's kind of depressing to put it like that, but... Honestly, you're
after a couple generations, no one remembers that the last couple generations before you.
You can go visit your great 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 granddaddy's grave, and I guarantee you won't shed a single tear that he's dead. I mean,
he lived how many hundreds of years ago?
Exactly. I mean, really, there's no one left alive to love some of these people that are still in the ground. I mean, they're not even in the ground anymore. They've done dissolved and become
nothing.
The only
thing left is a big rock that's in the way.
A big rock that says, hey, remember this guy?
No. Exactly.
So what's the plan for that? I mean, burying people still? Or whatever they want to do, just don't waste space? Mandatory cremation?
You have a few options. Like, I might let you be launched out into space.
Oh, yeah, that'd be a great grave.
Because you're going out in space and you're frozen.
Or just, like, launched straight at the sun.
Yeah, like...
Like, ultimate cremation, it feels like they're buried to you, so you don't... Because to some people, cremation is just like, damn, they're gone. But you launch them out into space at the sun, you're like, he got to see space. And then, unbeknownst to you, they're hurling towards the sun and burning up before
burials at sea, not without caskets, of course. Well, it really doesn't matter because it'll just be made in the coral anyways, with or without caskets.
Now, personally, I just want to be pushed out to sea in a flaming pyre.
Burial at sea will be allowed. Cremation will be allowed. Ejection into space will be allowed. Burial will be allowed, but only in rural areas.
I want someone to bury me on Pluto.
Anyone who lives in a citadel will not be getting buried unless they have relatives who also live out in a rural area and they want to be buried on, like, their
family. If they spend their luxury credits to buy some land, they can do whatever the fuck they want with it, including turning it into a family cemetery if they want.
But
buying land isn't going to be as easy as it is now.
Buying land's not really going to be a thing. It's just going to be living there and hoping you don't get destroyed by whoever else wants to live out there, because it's going to be a Badlands area.
Right.
If there's empty land space, you can go out there and live, but you have to be able to survive. And other people are out there living and surviving too, and they're crazy, and they might be doing
some of them are crazy.
Well, some of them are crazy. Some of them just like nature.
Some of them are crazy, some just want to live off the earth and shit.
And some of them want to kick you in the head.
Why? Why? What we sitting at?
19.
19? Okay, well, yeah. Any
17% battery.
Any closing statements? I plan on doing another video today just because while this is all still fresh in our minds, I want to go ahead and get it out there even if I don't upload them both this weekend.
Dress code type things, you have the right to wear whatever the fuck you want. I'm not going to tell you you can't be nude. You know why? You were born nude and males can walk around with their nipples hanging out. What's the difference between a male nipple and a girl nipple? Nothing.
The only difference is the fat surrounding it.
The only difference is it's been sexualized, and if you can't walk around without a boner all day, well, I guess you have a boner all day. Too bad. If you want to walk around nude, no one's going to complain. Except,
and, I mean, people will complain, but...
I'm not going to complain. Fuck them. Except for, I think there should be some thing around children.
Well, yeah. I mean, be decent, but, I mean, if you want to raise your children in a nudist aspect, fucking do it.
Yeah.
But, I mean, yeah. So. You have the right to do... wear, say, worship, and read whatever the fuck you want. That's the underlying basis.
So long as you're not harming or interfering with someone else's rights.
I don't care. I mean, okay, this video is getting a little long.
It's a little long. All right. The bottom line, your rights as a human in Utopia is to be a human, and that's it. Your right is to be you.
The way it should be today. It should be that you're right.
If you want to grow you a plant in your house, grow it. If you want to go outside and punch a wall until your arm breaks, well, you're an idiot, but do it. No one's going to stop you as long as you're not interfering.
If you
want to
go outside and pick
somebody.
A fight with the biggest black guy you can find, fucking do it.
Just make sure you don't injure no one else or you take it to a coliseum.
Right. As basically, your human rights are absolutely and completely limitless as long as they don't interfere with the laws and regulations of Utopia.
Exactly.
And that's what it boils down to. That's how it should be today. Of course, now we got so many laws going against our human rights that we can't even have human rights anymore. But that's all for this video, guys. So look forward to Utopia because this is some exciting shit. And I don't mean more interviews. I mean the actual world and solar system of Utopia. Because this is some exciting shit, and it's going to happen maybe in our lifetimes. So, if not, it'll happen in his lifetime, which is who knows how long. But that's all for today, guys. As always, laughter does good like a medicine. So keep watching, keep laughing, and keep living.
420 Blizz.
He's going to kick me in the head some more.
Yep. Bye.